Catherine from Nanjing Foreign Language School, Xianlin Classy. Today, I'm going to talk about the problem of overpopulation. Before I get started, I want to ask you a few questions first. Have you ever stopped to think about how many people share this planet with us? Will the excess of population drive humans to the doomsday? What if our resources can't catch up with our expanding population? Just stop for a second and think about these problems. Well, just now, I guess you're all expecting me to talk about something personal. My experience, my personal ideas, or whatever. You might wonder why I raised such a huge topic instead of talking about me personally. Indeed, many of you would feel like overpopulation has less to do with your lives compared to, for instance, your English learning skills, right? But you should realize that today, I'm not just talking about me personally. I am relating this to anyone who listened to my speech. You're all going to be protagonists experiencing what I'm going to say. So please draw your attention to the enduring concern that might soon affect our great generation greatly. Please ease yourself from personal issues and move to the topic that can change our human destiny. So back to the topic, talking about overpopulation. Many people believe that the Earth has a tough time supporting a large population with its limited resources. They raise the idea of overpopulation to show that the population will soon exceed the carrying capacity of the Earth. Now, let's first look at some notions that drive us to fear. Carrying capacity means the maximum number of people that the Earth can support. Edward Wilson from Harvard University once estimated that the overall carrying capacity of the Earth would be 9 to 10 billion. However, according to the United Nations, the population of the Earth will soon reach to 9 billion in 2046 and 10 billion by the end of this century. This seems very terrible, right? Indeed, many people believe this to be the doomsday or catastrophe. They send videos and messages on TikTok, YouTube, or Facebook, and other medias to express their worries and negativities. Nowadays, when we think about overpopulation, what appear in our minds are crowded cities, the lack of resources, and our unsustainable world on the brink of collapse. But have you ever doubted that the situation is not as terrible as we think? Is the problem of overpopulation really that irresolvable? For me, my answer is no. And I think overpopulation might seem to be a problem now, but it will no longer be a problem in the near future. To understand why I say this, please first follow me into the analysis of what causes overpopulation. At its core, overpopulation is not just a demographic issue. It's rather the conflict between the need for economic growth and our ecological constraints. We all know that economic growth is a central goal for governments worldwide. It is linked to prosperity, job creation, and improved living standards. To achieve this goal, many countries have adopted pronatalist policies. Pronatalist means promoting childbirth. These policies encourage people to have more children. The logic is very simple. More children mean a larger and expanding labor force, which can be essential for production and service industry. It can also lead to increased output, making capital and money flow in a domestic market. It can also lead to increased number of consumers, promoting the market demand. In a word, promoting childbirth and pronatalist policies can help a country grow in the economy. This is the economic incentive why so many countries still implement pronatalist policies like baby bonus, even when they face the problem of overpopulation. However, this economic imperative clashes with the reality of our planet's carrying capacity. Every ecosystem has a limited population it can support without degradation. when we exceed this capacity, we face a series of problems. Deforestation, water scarcity, and climate change, to name a few. This is the lasting conflict that makes us hesitate when we make decisions. We are reluctant to give up on the vitality brought by population growth. But while we're implementing pronatalist policies, the Earth is sending us warnings that we are reaching a tipping point. The conflict is clear between economy and ecology. So this is the center of this problem. When hearing this problem, you might be thinking, oh, we can stop economic activities in order to avoid this problem. The conflict doesn't seem so obvious and so irresolvable as you believe. Well, to address your issue and to address your doubt, let me explain this a little bit further. Just place yourself as a participant of the game. What will happen if I ask you to give up on your possibility to win just for a remote public goal? You might be thinking, why is it me who have to sacrifice? So it's the same for nations. They might ask, why should we, a single country, forego our economic activities and opportunities just for a goal and cost that seems so vast and far away from our immediate control? This is a fair question, since one always speaks for national pride and self-interest. There are 224 countries in the world, and we can't expect any of them and each of them to follow altruism and mutual trust. When a single country looks at this problem, they might be thinking, why should we sacrifice? And in that case, the social well-being and collective well-being might seem too far away to satisfy at the expense of immediate economic benefits that they can see. So this is why it's almost impossible to ask a country to give up on the economic activities to avoid overpopulation. So when hearing this, I guess we're all kind of hopeless on this issue. But I'll say again, don't be too pessimistic. Since conventional methods can't solve this problem, we can switch to contemporary methods to solve the problem. And surprisingly and happily, the development in technology, especially AI, shows as a beacon of hope to break through. Specifically, AI would help us in three ways. AI could improve our carrying capacity of the Earth, and AI could cut down the dependence of productivity on population growth. And last, AI could help us explore space, the outer space. So let me explain on these. First, I think we should realize the power of AI in resource management. AI has the potential to significantly enhance our resource-carrying capacity, giving us much more resources than expected. By analyzing data, AI can make predictions and recommendations of resources that are previously unimaginable. Imagine an agriculture system that automatically irrigates. This irrigation system can save water from evaporation and give us more resources than we expected. These are not mere fantasies. They are the possibilities that AI brings to the table and brings to us. In fact, just as same as what I believe, according to the first founder of OpenAI company, the person called Vinod Khosla, he suggested in his 12 predictions about the future, also a TED speech, that the idea that resources are going to be depleted is wrong. Humans' ability to discover and exploit resources will make significant breakthroughs with AI. Second and foremost, I want to say that AI could cut down the dependence of economy on population. Specifically, it cuts down the dependence of productivity on human labor. In a traditional society, we all rely on humans for manufacturing previously. And humans are like a central goal that we pursue. However, with the help of AI, we can change everything. Previously, without consistently growing population, we'll face a series of problems, and the economy will soon collapse. This is exactly the reason why countries and nations choose to encourage childbirth and implement pronatalist policies. But now, everything can be changed. We all know that AI is like a super helper that never gets tired. AI works at a level that is not only precise, but also quick, finishing tasks in mere seconds that may take us a whole day to finish. I want to say that AI brings us the possibility to replace human labor. In that case, countries and nations will no longer bother about the source of their labor, and they can implement antinatalist policies instead to limit population growth with no burden. Indeed, there are many examples of this, of AI replacing humans as a much better worker. AI is far more efficient than humans. For instance, Apollo Go is an autonomous driving system. It's already used in Wuhan, it's a city in China, to replace human taxi driver. It has a very strong advantage, cheap. Actually, AI has very low maintenance cost. It will only cost 4 yuan for it to travel 6 kilometers. Something interesting is that after it was released in Wuhan, thousands of people chose to wait for AI taxi drivers instead of humans. So this shows the strong advantage of AI compared to humans and its high credibility. And another example is the prevalence of AI in manufacturing. In Tesla, AI is used as automated assembly line. AI-powered robots have become standards for painting and assembling car parts. When a single country or when a single company looks at this problem, they would rather use AI instead of humans because AI will never ask for wages, complain about harsh surroundings, or be trapped in complicated social relationships, which are all disadvantages of human labor. They're quicker, they're fast, they're like more efficient, and they can finish more complicated tasks. So these are the important skills of AI that could bring us the possibility of solving the conflict between economy and ecology. Last, I would like to provide another wonderful idea that AI might enable us to achieve: space exploration. We all know that Elon Musk is now exploring the space, right? But do you know that Elon Musk regards AI as a powerful tool in exploring space? Specifically, Elon Musk has established the system called SpaceX, in which he incorporates elements of AI into it in order to let it make decisions independently. This shows the kind of prospect of AI also. So even if our two plans mentioned above fail, we can switch to another possible breaking point, which is migrating to outer space. So I believe with the help of development in technology and also AI, we can switch to tons of solutions that might be helpful for future, for human future and civilization. And last, I want to say something that I suddenly recall when I think about these just one day. After I thinking all about these one day, I suddenly recalled a very motivating sentence said by Zhang Xiaoyu. The first force that enlightens humanity has always been technology. People often overemphasize the influence of culture and spirit, word and trade on human history. But they often overlooked the fact that technology has secretly shaped us and promoted our social development. I want to end my speech by encouraging all of you that no matter what we encounter, we should always believe in the intelligence and collectivism that we inherently own. The kind of power and technology that we often dismiss will finally be our strongest weapon. Let us get rid of fear and negativity regarding our future, and let us bravely embrace and envision our bright future. Thank you all for listening.